organization working for a hunger-free world. Providing food, tends to more than 60 orphanages, old age homes, homes for differently abled and mentally challenged. We are in the path of service for the past 26 years, distributing more than 10,000 kgs of food grains, feeding more than 15,000 people and 2,000 animals every single month. The food grains distributed in the last 26 years has crossed well beyond 30 million meals. Apart from distributing food grains every year, we organize events for the welfare of the inmates of our beneficiary institutions by taking them on breakaway trips to Tirupati, theme parks, movie shows, wildlife sanctuaries, and other natural getaway. At the time of natural calamities, Chennai Food Bank has always been at the forefront by sending relief materials to the affected areas or by distributing food packets to the affected people without loss of time. All this has been possible because of the efforts and hard work put in by the trustees and their families, and also because of the generous donation and contribution from like-minded people and organizations. And now, today, we have a talk show, Take Charge of Your Life, on 1st March 2020, which is today, with the world-famous astrologer and Vastu expert, Dr.Jai Madaan. Dr.Jai Madaan is a renowned astrologer, Amish, faith leader, tarot reader, and Vastu expert, and popularly known as Lady of Fortune. She has helped many politicians, corporates, businessmen to solve their financial, marital, business, legal, and other problems. So we are looking forward for your participation in the talk show as well as support to the CFB in its noble cause.
So, I am recently associated with MFI and telling to you with the please honesty that I am very impressed by the work that is happening here because it is done under complete supervision, which is really nice. Secondly, I feel such organizations should be part of every city. You know, being in a metropolitan like Delhi, I feel that everybody of us wants to do everything for people, you know, but sometimes we're just not too comfortable giving money away. We just feel that what if the other person doesn't utilize it nicely. But each day when you're cooking a meal, and before that you take out a handful of grains, just like you do it to God, it's such a beautiful feeling. The happiness or the joy you will get, or the example that you will set for your children, it's such a nice thing. Rather, I think they should have give bigger jars also to people to put a packet of biscuit or things which have expired of at least 3 months every day, and sometimes maybe a packet of Maggie and things like that, which also gives a different sensation to the institutions and people, like we give it to our children. So if your child is buying 5 packets of chips in a week, maybe he can buy 6 and 1 goes to the jar. So it is, you know, you share. You don't give, you share. It's such a beautiful thing. I really like the idea.
Thank you so much. And another thing, I think I've been following you on Instagram and your social media handles. So out of my understanding, I figured out that you know, your healing, your predictions, everything is more inclined scientifically in an age where, you know, we are in a fast-moving modern world when there are, you know, absolute lot of astrologers and tarot readers and palm readers and all of that. But what I could figure out from your videos or whatever you're trying to, you know, create awareness about, it is all about that you have some scientific meaning to convey with everything that you, you know, put across. So we are all excited about today evening to hear it from you. So in a brief, you can tell us what are the subjects you'll be covering this evening.
I usually, people call me to talk about money. I think that's most important. So I'll be talking about prosperity, you know, as a whole. And other than that, you know, astrology and so whatever we do is something that we've got probably few years before independence, and then the invaders started coming to our lives. If you see our culture 1,000 years old, you will probably see no astrologer. You would have never heard of a term called astrologer. They were rishis. So they were rishis who used to tell only the rulers that this is how your house is supposed to be, this is how your way of living should be, this is how you should educate, and that is a set pattern of life. And of course, like all professions were exploited, this also became an exploited profession. So it is meant for people who are willing to change themselves and then bring a change in outer life. Nothing is going to happen outside. It has to start within. So yes, I do talk about things which are scientifically very appealing to me because I am a very logical person and intuitive as well. So something which doesn't fit here doesn't go down to my heart. You know, that's the way. दिमाग से दिल में जाया जाता है. सो आई रियली बिलीव दैट इफ यू आर लॉजिकली कन्विंस बाय समथिंग यू फॉलो इट बाय हार्ट.
थैंक यू. सो यू कन्विंस दैट दैट इज अ वे ऑफ लाइफ, इट्स जस्ट नॉट लिमिटेड टू प्रेडिक्शंस एंड रेमेडीज. थैंक यू. वी लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड टू हैविंग यू दिस मॉर्निंग.
मैम, एज अ एस्ट्रोलॉजर, हाउ चैरिटी इज गोइंग टू बी अ गुड लक टू द पीपल, बिकॉज़ ऑलवेज यू स्पोक अबाउट पीपल आर ओनली डिपेंडेंट ऑन मनी. सो हाउ एस्ट्रोलॉजी गिव्स अ टर्म ऑन चैरिटी.
सो एस्ट्रोलॉजी इज अ ब्यूटीफुल वे इन व्हिच अ वे ऑफ लिविंग हैज बीन टाइड विद अ रिचुअल सिस्टम, बिकॉज़ इफ यू रिपीट समथिंग अगेन एंड अगेन इट बिकम्स अ वे ऑफ लाइफ. So if you see astrology is all about Saturday donate oil, Wednesday donate green thing, Tuesday give this to little children, you know, in the form of sweet. So it always talks about sharing, not charity. Because when you do charity, you have to stand here and give. But when you share, you just share like friends, open different boxes and each other stuff. So astrology is telling you the way of getting into living by, if you're doing good, no planet is going to do harm to you. So that's the basic understanding of it, that you have to be good to receive good. I could really communicate and they could really understand the language, but I think for love there is no language.
Exactly. Your vibes should just touch them.
Not just vibes. I think the first sensation us as a human being that we got, you know, introduced to is the sense of touch. You know, when a child understands that now my mother is touching and a doctor is hanging me. So a child differentiates as a first touch is a closer sense organ which is affected to us. When you can't communicate with them, when you share your things or your money or your food with people, I always feel like subtly touching them. You know, you transfer your love and your emotions to them. So we just shouldn't be giving. We should be actually making them feel and give. So it has to go with love. So all I would just like to say that I love you all.
So much for watching this. Please do like, share and subscribe this channel. Thank you.